Well, good evening and welcome. A very happy Thanksgiving to all of you. So with a joyful heart then, why don't we sing the opening hymn, Sing to the Lord of Harvest, hymn number 893. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord, how manifold are your works. In wisdom have you made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. When you give it to them, they gather it up. When you send forth your Spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the ground.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live.
I will sing praise to my God while I have being. Tomorrow, as you know, is Thanksgiving, a day we set aside as a nation to give thanks to our God, who graciously gives us all things. In one of Paul's letters to Timothy, he urges that supplications and prayers and intercessions and thanksgivings be made for all people. For each one of us, there are people we struggle to be thankful for. God created this world and everything that is in it, including all of the people who live in it, according to God's gracious will. He desires all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. Here's the truth. God loves the people of this world so much that he sent his Son, Jesus, into the world so that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. By the command of Christ and through the power of the cross, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Gracious God, you provide us all we need for our bodies and lives. Lead us by your Holy Spirit to see and be thankful for all the blessings that you give us, thanking you with our lips and our lives. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated as we continue with our next hymn, Praise and Thanksgiving. Dan will sing verse 1, and then the congregation will sing verses 2 and 3.
Thanksgiving, Father, we offer for all things living, created good. Harvest of sown fields, fruit of the orchard, hay from the mown fields, blossom and wood. Bless, Lord, the providing food for your children, by your wise guiding, teach us to share one with another, so that rejoicing with us all others may know your care.
Our Old Testament reading then for this Thanksgiving Eve, it comes to us from the book of Deuteronomy, the 8th chapter, and is read as follows. Be careful to obey every command I give you today. Then you will live, and your population will increase. You will enter and take possession of the land that the Lord promised to your ancestors with an oath. Remember that for 40 years the Lord your God led you on a journey in the desert. He did this in order to humble you and to test you. He wanted to know whether or not that you would wholeheartedly obey his commands. So he made you suffer from hunger and fed you with manna, which neither you nor your ancestors had seen before. He did this to teach you that a person cannot live on bread alone, but on every word that the Lord speaks. Your clothes, they did not wear out, and your feet did not swell these past 40 years. Learn this lesson by heart. The Lord your God was disciplining you as parents discipline their children. Obey the command of the Lord your God. Follow his direction and fear him. The Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, and it is a land with rivers that don't dry up. There are springs and underground streams flowing through the valleys and hills. The land has wheat and barley, grapevines and fig trees and pomegranates. The land has honey and olive trees for olive oil. And the land will have enough food for you, and you will have everything that you need. The land has rocks with iron ore, and you will be able to mine copper ore in the hills. When you have eaten all you want, thank the Lord your God for the good land that he has given to you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. Our epistle reading then comes to us from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians, the 4th chapter. And here St. Paul reminds us, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. He writes, never worry about anything. But in every situation, Let God know what you need in prayers and request while giving thanks. Then God's peace, which goes beyond anything that we can ever imagine, will guard your thoughts and emotions through Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, keep your thoughts on whatever is right or deserves praise, things that are true and honorable and fair and pure, acceptable, commendable. Practice what you have learned and received from me. When you heard and saw me do, then the God who gives you this peace will be with you. For the Lord has filled me with joy because you again show interest in me. You were interested but did not have the opportunity to show it. I am not saying this because I am in need. I've learned to be content in whatever situation I'm in. I know how to live in poverty or prosperity. No matter what the situation, I've learned the secret of how to live when I'm full or when I am hungry, when I have too much or have too little. I can do everything through Christ who strengthens me. But nevertheless, it was kind of you to share in my troubles. You Philippians, you also know that in the early days that I left the province of Macedonia to spread the good news, you were the only church to share your money with me. You gave me what I needed, and you received what I gave you. Even while I was in Thessalonica, you provided for my needs not once, but twice. It's not that I am looking for a gift. The opposite is true. I'm looking for your resources to increase. For you have paid me in full, and I have more than enough. Now that Epaphroditus has brought me gifts, your gifts, you have filled my needs. Your gifts are a soothing aroma, a sacrifice that God accepts and with which he is well pleased. My God will richly fill your every need in a glorious way through Jesus Christ. So glory belongs to our God and Father forever. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. We will continue with our next hymn, Give Thanks with a Grateful Heart. Dan will sing it through once, and then we will sing it afterwards.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ his Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ his Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks, give thanks, give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ his. as he's given, Jesus Christ, his Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. Give thanks.
Please stand. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 17th chapter. And here Jesus gives healing to the 10, but only one returns to give thanks. Luke writes, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee, and on his way to Jerusalem. And as he went into a village, 10 men with a skin disease, they met him. They stood at a distance and they shouted, Jesus, teacher, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he told them, show yourselves to the priests. As they went, they were all made clean. When one of them saw that he was healed, he turned back and praised God in a loud voice. He quickly bowed at Jesus' feet and thanked him. This man was a Samaritan. And Jesus asked, weren't 10 men made clean? Where are the other 9? Only this foreigner came back to praise God. Jesus told the man, get up and go home. Your faith has made you well. This is the gospel of the Lord. We confess together, I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and he sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated as we sing our next hymn, We Praise You, O God, hymn number 785.
Struggles we win.
and gladly our songs of thanksgiving we raise. With you, Lord, beside us, your strong arm will guide us to you, our great Redeem, forever.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, as you know, tomorrow, of course, is Thanksgiving. And it is a day that we as Americans, we have set aside for a particular purpose. We have set it aside to give thanks for God. At least, that's what we're supposed to do. Unfortunately for many, it turns into a day of only being with family, to eat lots of nice food, and to watch all the football games. The Thanksgiving part of Thanksgiving, it goes unnoticed and even ignored by some. But obviously, that's not the case with you, nor it is with me. We're here this evening because we know that God expects our thanksgiving for all his good gifts, today, tomorrow, and every day. So we're here to do just that, and that is to offer God our thanks and our praise as he blesses us with his gracious gifts. I don't know about you, but I got to ask the question, where does one begin? I mean, after all, God gives us gift upon gift upon gifts. So I took to heart St. Paul's words. Meditate on them as I read them once again. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus. You see, St. Paul is reminding us that God has given us everything that we need. Luther himself goes to great lengths to explain the gifts that God gives us. He preaches the truth in the Small Catechism, where he explains the first article of the Creed as he writes, God has given us our bodies and our soul and our eyes and our ears and all our members, our reason and all of our senses, and still takes care of them. Then he goes on to say, but don't forget, he also gives us clothing and shoes and food and drink and house and home and spouse and children and land and animals and all that we have. He richly and daily provides us with all that we need to support this body and life. Then he goes on to say, and by the way, he defends us against all danger and guards and protects all of us from the evil one. All this he does out of his goodness and mercy, without any merit or worthiness in us. For all this, it is our duty to thank and praise, serve and obey God. You see, that's the standard, if you will, Thanksgiving Day sermon. But you know, you hear that year out and year out. And really, God gives us so much more to be thankful. Luther said it, St. Paul says it, and even God himself says it. It is our duty to thank the Lord our God for all the gifts he gives to us. God gives us everything that we need to live in this world. So it's true. We don't need to be anxious about anything. God gives us faith in Christ. And through that faith, we receive forgiveness, life, and salvation. Through his sacred mysteries, which are known as Word and Sacraments, he also forgives us, gives us life and salvation. So we can offer up our prayers and supplications to God with thanksgiving. But you see, here's the thing. Here's the thing that makes Thanksgiving so different. So different than how it is in the rest of the world out there. God has rescued you and me. And he's done that from sin, death, and the devil. And we might even go as far as to say he has rescued us from hell. We can live here on earth in the peace of heaven, the peace that passes all human understanding. God keeps and guards our hearts and our minds in and with and through Christ our Lord. So that means that you and I have confidence in the promises of God to sustain us in every need, to deliver us in every trial, and to welcome us at last to our heavenly home. About you, but tonight and tomorrow and every day of my life, what better reason to say and to pray, thank you, God. You see, these are the things as Christians for which we are most thankful, especially this Thanksgiving and every other day as well. Now, I don't know about you, but you look at the world, right? You look at the world and what do you see? Not much to be thankful for. With the pandemic still ongoing and the tragedy that we just experienced in Waukesha and all the things that we see in this world, it creates doubt in our minds, doesn't it? That we really don't have a lot to be thankful for. But Paul tells us, hey, that isn't so. You have a lot to be thankful for. In fact, you have more gifts than you can ever imagine. You see, here's the thing. It's true that we are thankful for everything. We are also thankful that by virtue of our birth, we are blessed to live in a country where we can freely offer our praise and worship to God. We certainly have much to be thankful for. So today we gather here with Christ. He is in our midst. We are here to give him thanks. Tomorrow and the day after that and after that and after that, every day of our life, God expects the same. That doesn't have to happen in the church. But certainly it should happen in your homes and with your families. And while you eat and watch TV all day tomorrow, or some of us have a work day tomorrow. Right, Dan? Work day somewhat. Remember tomorrow, like every day, to give thanks. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, give thanks to God for all the blessings. Now, some of you may not have plans for tomorrow. I know that, and so does God. But for many, Thanksgiving Day will just look like every other day of the year. For some, that day is spent alone, with the same old routines, the same old struggles, the same old sorrows, with nothing noticeable different about it. Even if that is the case, it's still a day to give thanks to God. Whether you spend it tomorrow with family or by yourself, we all have a great and gracious gift for which to be thankful for. And I think you know where I'm going with this. That gift is Jesus Christ. And he truly is a gift. You see, Jesus himself tells us in the Gospel of St. John, for God so loved the world. That's you. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son. That's Jesus. That whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You see, Jesus is the greatest gift to all of us. He took on our flesh all the way to the cross. He took up his cross so that you and I could take up heavenly glory. He took on death for us, and he won for us, and now by his grace, we are saved from all of that, sin, death, and the devil. And now you and I are destined. Destined for that feast in heaven, for the resurrection to life everlasting, and the eternal glory in the awesome presence of the Almighty. Now, I must admit, I could be up here for hours on end talking about all the gifts God has given us. But I'm so thankful for one particular. And that is not only Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, but for all of you who are members of this congregation. You're wonderful, and you are a child of God. So whether we spend tomorrow with friends or by ourselves, we will all spend tomorrow with Jesus. That's the point I want to make. All of us will spend tomorrow with Jesus. And we will spend tomorrow as we spend every other day as the children of God, giving thanks to Christ for his salvation. So go. Be thankful for his great love. Be thankful for his gift to us of everlasting salvation. My dear friends in Christ, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, and his mercies endureth forever. So I want to close then with the reading from St. Paul here. And he starts in Philippians, the 4th chapter. He goes, "Therefore, my brothers, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm. Thus in the Lord," he calls them his beloved, "rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say it, rejoice. Let your reasonableness be known to everyone. For the Lord is at hand. Remember now, don't be anxious about anything. But in everything, whether it's by prayer or supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in and through Christ Jesus." And then he says, "Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about those things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, practice these things, and the God of peace will be with you." Very comforting words, isn't it? As we live in this world, even though we're not of this world, Thanksgiving is a day to give thanks to God. And remember, God is always with you through the thick and thin of things. So let us give thanks to God by saying amen. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, may he keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus to life everlasting. Amen. We will continue then with our offering, and then, of course, the solo, "Jesus, Thank You."
The mystery of the cross I cannot comprehend, the agonies of Calvary. Perfect Holy One crushed your Son, who drank the bitter cup reserved for me. Your blood has washed away my sin. Jesus, thank you. The Father's wrath completely satisfied. Jesus, thank you. Once your enemy, now seated at your table, Jesus, thank you. By your perfect sacrifice, I've been brought near.
enemy you've made your friend. Pouring out the riches of your glorious grace, your mercy and your kindness know no end. Your blood has washed away my sin. Jesus, thank you. The Father's wrath completely satisfied. Jesus, thank you. Once your enemy, now seated at your table. Jesus, thank you. Satisfied, Jesus, thank you. Once your enemy, now seated at your table, Jesus, thank you.
Please stand. So let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and all people according to their needs. Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you, Lord, for Jesus Christ, your only Son, through whom you give us the gifts of forgiveness and eternal life in your kingdom. Hear us as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So may God be gracious to us and bless us. Let us always thank God for his goodness. Let us always give thanks. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Please be seated. I would like to wish everyone a very happy Thanksgiving tomorrow. Remember to exercise, right? Don't eat too much, but give thanks to God. And just a couple announcements here. We encourage you to come to our Advent Christmas concert, which is Wednesday, December 1st. Remember, there's a chicken dinner at 5:30. So if you plan on coming, please make sure that we know at the church so that we can make sure we got enough food. So chicken dinner at 5:30 and the concert. Now, it is a wonderful concert. I'm not going to spoil it for you, but we have just a fantastic lineup, okay? I never will make a great announcer, would I? The whole point I'm trying to say is that please put that on your calendar and come, because it's a wonderful thing. We have close to 40 musicians with choirs and everything, so please come for that. Pass the word. Remember that. Also, Christmas caroling. We ask that you would join us to enrich the neighborhood with singing Christmas carols on December 19th at 4:30. And then, of course, we will have, you know, we'll be cold and stuff, so come and enjoy the hot chili supper, which will follow at 6 o'clock. So please do that. And remember, Christmas Eve candlelight service is December 24th. You can see the time there, it's 4:30. And again, Christmas Day service is at 9:30. So spread the word and then bring your families, your neighbors, your friends. I don't bite, only on Sunday, right? So, boy, I'm really bombing out tonight, aren't I? But nevertheless, we want to say thank you, and we give God thanks for our food bank here as we gave out 10 bags tonight. So that's good for our food bank. So that's really good. So with all of that said, why don't we close with a grateful heart, and we'll sing Hallelujah. Let praises ring. Hymn number 822. May you have a blessed Thanksgiving.
Songs of adoration to Him through everlasting days. Be worship, honor, power, and praise, whose hand sustains creation. Singing, ringing, holy, holy, God is holy, spread the story of our God, the Lord of glory. Alleluia, let praises ring. Unto the Lamb of God we sing, in whom we are elected. Bought His church with His own blood, He cleansed her in that blessed flood, and as His bride selected, holy, holy is our union and communion, His befriending gives us joy and peace unending. Unto the Holy Ghost we sing for our regeneration. The saving faith in us He wrought, and us unto the Bridegroom brought, made us His chosen nation. Glory, glory, joy eternal, bliss supernal, there is manna and endless glad hosanna. Alleluia, let praises ring, unto our triune God we angel host, let us adore and sing his praises evermore. For all his grace and favor, sing.